In this illustration, we'll further discuss a circuit of equivalent capacitance where the circuit is symmetrical. Here we are given that each capacitor in the circuit shown is of capacitance C, and we are required to determine the equivalent capacitance of circuit across terminals X and Y. Here again we solve it by distribution of potentials for which we connect a 100 volt battery across the circuit. We assume on the negative side of the battery the potential is 0 and on the higher potential side it is 100 volt. And by symmetry here we can say that if at one node here potential is X, then obviously by symmetry here also potential will be X. And due to input and output symmetry we can say if the potential difference across this capacitor is X, across this must also be X. So here the potential must be 100 minus X. And here also by symmetry the potential will be 100 minus X. If we talk about this point, the potential difference across this capacitor and this capacitor must be same. So here we can say here potential will be 50 volts because of symmetry across 0 and 100 volt point. Now if we get the value of X, we can easily calculate the total charge which is flown through the battery from one side to another, say it is delta QF. Then this charge will be deposited on these three plates, or from these three plates whichever charge is extracted that will be deposited on these three plates. Whether it is positive or negative, we are only concerned with magnitude. So it won't make any difference whichever direction I take the flow of charge. So in this situation we can write down the equation for X to calculate the potential X. Here to X these three plates are connected. I can write down the charges of these three plates. So charge on this plate will be C multiplied by X minus 0. Plus charge on this plate will be C multiplied by X minus 50. Plus charge on this plate will be C multiplied by X minus of 100 plus X. That should be equal to 0. Here C gets cancelled out. Now simplifying, getting 4X is equals to 150, which gives the value of X is 75 by 2 volt. So if we have got the value of X, we can find out the charge flown through battery, which is delta QF, and the sum of these three charges, which is CX plus C multiplied by 50, because potential here is 0. So this will be C multiplied by 2X plus 50. And using this, I can find out the equivalent capacitance across CXY, which is delta Q, which is flown through battery by battery EMF. So this will be C multiplied by twice of 75 by 2 plus 50 divided by 100. So this is C multiplied by 125 by 100. That can be written as 5C by 4. That is the answer to this problem. Let us also analyze an alternative method to solve the same problem of equivalent capacitance of the symmetry circuit. Here we are given with a circuit of capacitors across terminals X and Y. We know well that if we apply a battery across the terminals and say the potentials here are 0 and 100, then we have recently seen that we can distribute potential X and X here by symmetry. And at this point potential will be 100 minus X and 100 minus X. Now in this situation, there is one more method we can realize over here, that if these two points are at same potential, if we connect these two points by a straight conducting wire, there should not be any charge flow between the two. Similarly, if we connect these two points with a straight wire, there should again not be any charge flow between the two. So in this situation we can flip the upper part of circuit on the lower part like this by considering this middle line as axis. So this X will come over here, this 100 minus X will also come over here, and the equivalent circuit after flipping the upper part will look like this. This terminal X, these two capacitors will remain same as C and C, the middle one rest all capacitors. The upper one will come in parallel with the lower one, you can see. When this point will come over here, this C and C will be in parallel, this C and C in parallel. You can see all upper capacitor will come in parallel with the lower capacitor. So the circuit will look like this. And if we connect these capacitors in parallel, the equivalent capacitance here will be 2C, 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 2C and 2C. Now in this situation, if your potential is 0 and your potential is 100, obviously as this is the midpoint of the circuit, potential here will be 50. So if we isolate this junction and we separate these two parts also, we can write after isolating junction at 50 volt node, then we can redraw the circuit like this. Across the terminals X and Y, the circuit can be drawn like this. This is C and C, and here this is 2C. This is also 2C. Here also this circuit is having capacitance 2C. And if we isolate it, it will look like this. This is 2C. And this will also look 2C. In this situation, if your potential is 0 and 100, we can say at both of these points, being midpoints of the circuit, potential will remain 50 and 50. But by rearranging the circuit to this form, now we can get the equivalent capacitance across X, Y by simply using series and parallel combination, like the upper two capacitor in series will be C by 2. And the lower capacitor we can write 2C and 2C in series will be C, and C in parallel with 2C will be 3C, and 3C in series combination with the 2C and 2C. So 2C and 2C in series will be C, and C in series with the 3C can be written as 3C by 4. So here we can write C across terminal XY can be written as 1C by 2 in parallel combination with the 3C by 4. So the result we are getting is 5C by 4. That is the answer to this problem. So this method, you practice, then this is much more useful method for using series parallel analysis in case of symmetry circuits. But you need to be very careful, as nodal analysis is a logical and mathematical method by which we have calculated it on the previous sheet. And here we are manipulating circuit in a different form, finally reducing the circuit to a different form of manipulation and getting the equivalent capacitance by using series parallel analysis.